Corrupt dumb congresswoman just busted stealing money from children. What she did with money will make you sick. And once again we have a Democrat congressperson excelling at what they do best, lying, cheating and stealing. She partied with the Obama, Pelosi, and Reid, traveled on Air Force One next to President Obama, and cast her superdelegate vote for crooked Hillary Clinton, although they delegates should have gone for socialist Bernie Sanders. But today Corrine Brown is in federal court for stealing scholarship money from school children. Yes, you read that correctly, the woman of the people, stole money. From children. The disgraced congresswoman must now defend herself against allegations that she funneled hundreds of thousands of dollars from a non-profit charity, One Door for Education, into her own filthy pocket. If convicted on all 24 counts, she faces 357 years in prison and $4.8 million in fines. Only a Democrat being a Democrat. From the very beginning, Brown has been shrouded in deep controversy. Right after winning her election in 1992, the Federal Election Commission accused Brown of violating numerous campaign finance laws. And that was even before the campaign finance laws became strict under the McCain-Feingold law that forced the creation of so-called super PACs. Most notably, she accepted donations from foreign citizens and even failed to report the use of a corporate plane which she managed to get her greasy paws on. And investigators are saying that's just the tip of the ethical iceberg. Corrine Brown pleads for mercy, prosecutors ask for prison time. Former Jacksonville area Congresswoman Corrine Brown took the stand Thursday afternoon, pleading for mercy from federal judge Timothy Corrigan. "I am sorry you have to be here today to see me in this situation," Brown said in her statement to the court. "I never imagined I would one day be in court asking people to speak on my behalf, never. In hindsight, I wished I had been more diligent in overseeing my personal and professional life. The idea that some people could believe these charges hurt me because it runs contrary to everything I've ever believed and done in my life. I hope and pray these proceedings to don't make them, ordinary people, lose faith in the system. I humbly ask for mercy and compassion." Brown was convicted on 18 counts of fraud and corruption in May. The lead prosecutor in the sentencing hearing argued Thursday that the former congresswoman should be sentenced to about 7.5 to 9 years in federal prison. Her defense attorney is seeking probation and community service. Prosecutor Tyson Duva told the court based on her actions during the investigation and in the trial, she should receive the most prison time out of the three co-conspirators. Brown wore a magenta suit to the courthouse Thursday and briefly appeared in the overflow courtroom prior to the sentencing hearing. Brown's defense attorney James Smith objected to various aspects of the sentencing recommendations, including how much money Brown should be culpable for. Prosecutor Duva asked the court, "What accountability does the law require?" During his presentation, Duva said Brown was accustomed to receiving money she should not have received. She also lied about donations to colleges, churches, and other entities. He also argued that Brown has made ludicrous comments during the investigation, including a comment where she essentially said that had investigators not been looking into her case, the Pulse shooting in Orlando would never have happened. She also referred to the charges as bogus and racist, implying that she was targeted for her race in the case. Duva objected to that notion by saying, "She was targeted because she committed fraud, not because she was black or white." She attacked numerous agencies during the investigation, which Duva states shows her character as a person. "Why do you support someone who says this nonsense?" Duva questioned the court Thursday, referring to the upcoming character witnesses set to speak. We're in our first break for Corrine Brown's sentencing hearing. U.S. Attorney Tyson Duva just completed the government's presentation. He passionately described her as a trailblazer politician who morphed into a liar and a fraud. At fcn2gopic.twitter.com web link Julia Ginny, at Julia Genfgen, November 16, 2017. Duva claims Brown failed miserably at being transparent during her time in office as a congresswoman. "This is systemic and this is who she became," said Duva, arguing the character witnesses cannot overshadow the conduct she performed in the criminal case. It's not something that should be present in American democracy, he said. Duva said the judge has to make a difficult decision in this case. Corinne Brown and her attorney James Smith speak outside the federal courthouse Monday. Photo, First Coast News. Brown has previously asked for delays in her sentencing due to storm damage to her home and mental and physical welfare checks, but all those motions were denied. On Wednesday, prosecutors recommended reduced prison time sentences for Brown's co-conspirators, former of Chief of Staff Ronnie Simmons and fake charity founder Carla Wiley. Judge Tim Corrigan accepted this recommendation for a reduced prison time range of 21-27 months for Wiley and 33-41 months of Simmons. More on that hearing can be read here. Brown, Simmons and Wiley will not receive their final sentencing until December 4, according to recent court documents. Corinne Brown character witness testimony, November 16, 2017. Corinne Brown had several witnesses come forward Thursday in support of her through witness testimony during the sentencing hearing. Congresswoman Sheila Jackson Lee provided a glowing character witness of Corinne Brown during her sentencing hearing Thursday. Jackson Lee described via telephone testimony it as her privilege to characterize Corinne Brown as a loving person. She said Brown has had a pointed and direct effort in helping others, not herself. The veterans community loved Congresswoman Brown, Jackson Lee said, stating that Brown has helped those with PTSD and other issues following fighting overseas. She also stated Brown helped tremendously with relief efforts during Hurricane Katrina in New Orleans. That shows a character of giving to others unselfishly, Jackson Lee said. A bishop from the Orlando area stated that Brown would help their community when other politicians couldn't make things happen. He said she was driven by wanting to support and bless others. One woman who went to school with Brown's daughter got emotional during her testimony in support of Brown. She said Brown taught her valuable lessons that helped her thrive in her military career and how to treat her soldiers. She's been my champion, my mentor, the woman said. Dr. Oliver Hunter of Houston recommended that Brown receive community service instead of incarceration time. Another witness came forward and said Brown should be out helping others instead of in jail because the people trust her. Melissa Alexander came forward to speak on behalf of Brown, describing her as a blunt and passionate woman. She cited that she's been supportive of other people even up to the sentencing hearing. Marissa Alexander,